Okay, here we are at the back of the ATV. We're at the very back end of the space station. We're going 18,000 miles an hour in this direction. And so I'm going to kick off and we'll do a quick fly through the stack of the International Space Station. We'll pass some fun things on the way. Oh, don't be with it. Dinner table again, got backs.
It's very difficult to squeeze through the Russian segment.
Especially when Max is here. And now we're going through into the FTB. Looks like we got a nice flight path here. Should be able to make it. Alright, down into node 1, station's gonna open up. Butch, go high! Quick foot tag, quick aileron roll through the lab, into the ball form. A little spin into node 2 over Alex's crew quarters. And here we are at the very front end of the International Space Station. Still going 18,000 miles an hour.
Elon Richardson, okay? He asks, do they plan to deorbit space station?
Yeah, what are they going to do about that, Don?
They're going to deorbit space station at the end of its life, whenever that is. And in concept, we could keep it flying for a long, long time. We have airplanes that were designed and built in the mid-50s.
The T-38s that we fly. Late 50s,
early
60s.
They were designed 60s. In the 50s, built in the 60s, and you just keep rebuilding the airframe, rebuilding the engines, upgrading the avionics, and you could fly these things basically till you run out of gas. And in concept, we could do that with station, and we could keep the station running for as long as we like, basically up until we reach the end point of the structural elements on station. And when that time does come, we will have to deorbit it.
We're going at least till 2024.
Yeah, we're going to.
So, like with Hubble, what we did on our mission is we put a docking ring on the bottom of the telescope.
Yeah.
Because we want to ensure a guided entry. When the thing is done, they're going to send maybe 20, 30 years from now. I mean, science may be done. Hopefully, we have a lot more science with Hubble. But even if the science stops, the spaceship can still continue to orbit, right?
Yeah.
Just by orbital mechanics, eventually it's going to come in. So we have a docking ring on the bottom of Hubble for a rocket motor. No one has to be there. It could be an automated thing. Dock with it and guide it so it doesn't hit anyone on the way down. So do they have anything like that for station? Because that's a big thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So when it deorbits, is it going to be a controlled deorbit?
It'll be a controlled deorbit. We'll use a Russian Progress vehicle. And instead of reboosting station, you'll point the rocket thrusters the other way.
To slow down. They'll probably do that so that the major part of the reentry is over the ocean.
The Pacific
is a really big ocean, and that would be the right place to put it.
Yeah.
So in case anything survives coming in. So you're not going to recover anything
from
the space station. Okay. Let's
see another one.
Yeah, this is Nile, this big green one.
So you got a great shot of the Nile.
Very clear.
Beautiful day today.
Yeah.
So there we got coming up on the
This is the Red Sea, yeah. And that Suez Canal over there, you can probably point at
that. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
there you go.
So Red Sea and then just
Suez Canal
of Cairo, Suez Canal, very thin. See that.
passing just across the southern coast of Ireland into the Bristol Channel and then east to right over London. It's supposed to be pretty cloudy, except the channel may be clear and London itself might be clear, so we'll see. Here's the Strait of Dover. See all the runoff. Yeah, let's go overhead. It's coming in view.
I see London's in that. See that area right there, kind of
where that bay is.
The bay is, yeah. That's London. Let's see if you can actually see anything in London.
There it is. So we're almost directly overhead.
Yep.
Finally catching a break though from the rain.
You look closely, see Sicily and Italy coming over the horizon. Give you a close zoom in on the volcano. Beautiful. And then the easily recognizable boot of Italy coming into view. It's quite a bit different than it does on maps from up here. But there it is, there's it, the boot of Italy. I've been to Italy just one time, but I plan on going back there soon. My family immigrated from Italy about 100 years ago. My grandparents and great-grandparents. Right off our left side, we're going to be losing it behind the structure pretty soon. There's Greece. Got a good friend from Greece growing up. Excellent food. In most of Europe, there's excellent food.
Yeah, that'll be the Bay Area, and then if you come just...
Yes. San Francisco is
right, oh yeah, right of trajectory, yeah.
Yep.
Left of trajectory.
Left of trajectory.
He does a great shot of San Francisco.
So interesting enough, right there is Edwards Air Force Base. That's another place where I lived.
You can see it. Those big dry lake beds. That's also where Palmdale and Lancaster are,
which
where the space shuttle.
Right, of course.
Space shuttle was built.
Was built down there, yeah.
Okay, that should be Houston. Try to get it in the camera.
It's like a beautiful day. I just talked to my wife at home just 15 minutes ago. She said the weather's beautiful down there.
There it is, Houston, Texas.
Chicago?
Yeah, it's at the bottom of Lake Michigan. Did you get it?
Here's Chicago, kind of swinging off to our left. So you got, there's Long Island, there's New York City. Looks a little snowy down there.
It does look snowy. Looks like a lot of snow down there.
Nice clear day, probably very cold. Long Island, and there's Connecticut. My home state, my hometown of Waterbury.
That little dot?
It's not even, you can't even see it, it's so small. Let's get a New York City, one more close up of New York City. New York, are you ready for your close-up from the International Space Station? Looking good.
Enjoy your Friday night.
Friday night in New York.
It's the end of January, and soon I'll be getting ready to leave. I came up here last September, 6 weeks before Rick and Koichi, so my time is nearly up. It's gonna be good to see my wife Julie and the boys, Ryan and Lucas.
We are exactly 6 weeks away from when Mike will be landing here back in Houston. Not that I'm counting. Starting to become real that he's gonna be home soon. So I'm pretty excited about that. I can't believe it's almost here.
Before launch, I coached them in lacrosse and hockey.
Can you see?
Yep, sure can. Where's Lucas playing though? I can't tell.
He's center. He's breathing on life right now.
Fortunately, we have a video link, so I've been able to keep track of their games and be there in spirit, if not in person.
Oh no.
That's all right. Keep fighting back.
It was really fun because my son got to take a penalty shot and actually scored, so that was fun for Mike to see. It was really exciting for him. He feels a little bit more connected to the kids because I know it's hard. I know he misses that stuff a lot.
Oh yeah, it's about that time. Here we go. We're sure if we're gonna make it out today, but it looks like we're gonna go.
We're gonna rent out your place real soon, don't worry about it.
Yeah? I cleaned it, so it should be ready to go. Yeah. You getting excited, Rick? I'm getting excited.
See Mike Hopkins, NASA astronaut, giving a quick wave farewell there. And physical separation confirmed.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks, Oleg. Thanks for getting me home.
You're being assimilated by the
assimilator.
Pull out quickly, yo, oh, dude. Oh,
no. This is gonna get worse and worse.
We film it.
Dude, this is amazing.
Look at that. Whoa.
Holy smokes.
Oh my gosh.
That is absolutely fascinating.
Here's one from Peter Manley.
Mm-hmm.
Would a balloon pop in space?
So this is interesting.
Well, a balloon, will pop if you blow it inside a station, because right. I've done that, because I brought some balloons for my kid's birthday celebration.
And I didn't know that.
I accidentally
that.
Popped one, and they go bang.
Did you get in trouble for it? Did your kids complain about that?
No,
did they know about it?
They didn't know about it. But anyway,
here's dad doing his best to have a birthday party in space, and by mistake one balloon goes and could ruin the whole party.
Yeah. But it's neat to blow a balloon up and then let go of it. It goes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
But that's all you. That's propulsion there. It behaves differently than what you have on the ground.
Yeah, because it doesn't have the effects of gravity. It doesn't go in a parabolic arch.
It just
goes, and then it just stops.
That's great. So, it doesn't fall to the ground.
Yeah, it doesn't fall to the ground.
All right, cool.
But in the vacuum of space, like outside.
I'm wondering, if that's what he means, that because you have less pressure.
Yeah, well, I think what would happen would be it would just keep expanding and expanding and expanding, and then it would rupture on its own.
Right. I think similar like a bag of potato chips in an airplane.
Yeah.
When you go up on an airplane and you're at less pressure, the bag becomes inflated.
Yeah.
Wonder how quick do you think it would happen? I think it would happen.
I think it
would
happen real quick. Yeah, you want to get out of the airlock.
Say in space, in the vacuum, and that thing would go quickly.
Okay, let's see.